Hello everyone, my name is Paul Mayo. You're back for another edition of Pokemon Y Shiny Hunt. This is the episode, 640. Sorry, I had to think about that. Episode 640, and it's going to be Pokemon Y Shiny Hunting for Binette. This is Thursday, so, I believe it's both Pokemon X and Y this happens, but I'm playing Pokemon Y, of course, that's why I said the title. But anyways, yeah, so, in the Lost Village, not a Lost Village, a Pokemon Village, the Shaking Trash Bins on those days, they have a chance to have Binette as the Pokemon encounter when you, check the Shaking Trash Bin. Usually what you do, of course, is save right before the Trash Bin, and then you just keep, encountering until you see what it is, because once it's either Garbodor or Binette, usually it's Garbodor on, like, every single day. It's just, like I said, it's a chance to have one of them. Like, it's only on Thursdays that Binette can come out. But once you get a certain one, you just like stick with it, because especially for me, like I'm recording and stuff like that, so it's kind of like whatever it is, like whatever file I'll take. Even though I call Binette, it's like the same with on the Tuesdays, it would be having a chance to be Rotom, but it's not always. It could be like Trubbish or Garbodor. So yeah, but anyways, since I'm getting Garbodor is clearly, I'm going to be saying the name for the shiny Garbodor when I hopefully find it and do catch it. So Shiny Garbodor's color, instead of the normal green it has, it's kind of like a light blue. So I thought of something that was trash, but also could be treasure, that was also blue. So I started to think of the Ocarina from Legend of Zelda Ocarina of Time. So that is what I'm going to be basing the name off of, and it's pretty much the name would be Ocarbodor. So that's pretty much what I'll be calling it whenever I do find it and catch it, like I said. Anyways, the topic for this episode is by me. It's about Kirby Superstar. It's pretty much what was the most annoying and or hardest level that you've gone through in that game, and did you defeat it? So, that is really tough. It can be like any of the levels, or it can just be like a whole world that's tough. But if I remember, the toughest one in my opinion, what would that be? One that really comes to mind is in the cave offensive mode, where it's like, you collect the treasures, and then eventually when you go around, loop back to where you started, you like go underground and up to there, and then you're able to escape. But anyways, one of the treasure rooms areas that you have to go in is like this weird track that you have to use the wheel power-up to get through it. And you press a button all the way near the entrance from where you enter in, and you keep going to the right until you get to the little switch that, like, how it opens that, how do you call it? It's like the thing that goes down from the ceiling and then it goes back up. It's like acts as a wall. When it's like pressed, it goes up, and then eventually when the time runs out, it'll go back down. So pretty much you had to be really good with like perfect jumping and everything and make it through that because it was timed. So it was really tough. So it took me a lot of tries, but I finally did get that, and it just feels good whenever you, like I said, I did defeat that, and it was definitely the most annoying, I want to say level, but it was more of like a room, so I guess that would count as well, whatever's like the most annoying or hardest for you. Whatever part, it can be like that whole room, or it can just be that certain part, the main aim of the room, that room existing, so yeah, it's pretty much... That is definitely the most annoying, and that was the hardest for me, so I'm curious to know what was yours, personally, if you even have one, because you could, just not care about the game at all, but I'm just curious to know, because I told you mine, so, yeah, might as well ask. All right, I'll end off episode 640.